చేస్తున్నాడా?
అంటే ప్రొఫైల్ అన్నయ్యది పెట్టా సార్.
సరే రైట్. ఐ రిపీట్, రే ఆప్టిక్స్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ హౌ ఎ రే ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రాపగేట్ త్రూ ఎన్ ఆప్టికల్ ఫైబర్. దేర్ ఆర్ టూ సచ్ రేస్ దట్ క్యాన్ ప్రాపగేట్ త్రూ ఆప్టికల్ ఫైబర్స్. దే ఆర్ మెరిడియనల్ రేస్ అండ్ స్క్యూ రేస్. నౌ స్పీకింగ్ అబౌట్ మెరిడియనల్ రేస్, these rays are confined to a single plane. Confined to a single plane means they are restricted to a single plane only. That means they travel only in a straight path, and these rays can be tracked very easily. Now these meridional rays are classified into two types: bounded rays and unbounded rays. Now we know that optical fiber consists of core and cladding. The core will have refractive index n1, cladding will have refractive index n2, in such a way that refractive index of core is always greater than refractive index of cladding. This n is greater than n2. This is the primary and foremost condition. Then the rays will travel from core and then to cladding. Now the rays which are trapped in a core are called as bounded rays. Now the rays which are refracted from core and coming out of the cable are called unbounded rays. I once again repeat, bounded rays are the rays which are trapped in a core and these move along the fiber only. They do not come out of the fiber. These rays are called bounded rays. And the rays that are refracted from core and coming out of the fiber are called as unbounded rays. Now this is everything about meridional rays what I have spoke till now. Now I am speaking of skew rays. These are not confined to a single plane, and these will follow a zigzag path. Zigzag path means they move in a helical path, a spring like path, and these are difficult to be tracked. And these are difficult to be tracked. And one more disadvantage of this is they lead to greater power loss. I hope you understood the concept of this ray theory. Now here I am ending the session. Again we will join at 2:30 today. Okay, I'm ending the session now.